everyone.
You're watching a very special show.
Because we've taken over.
You're watching the Spice Girls
on Shop and Ever.
It's funny because we was all like, oh my God, this is Top of the Pops. So yeah, it's like, you know, we always used to say, I feel like a properly famous person now.
I remember when we first got on the stage, we were like, oh my God. You know, you get really excited. It's like, ah.
When Wannabe first went to number one, it took weeks and weeks before we got back to England to be able to get here and do it. So it was like, wow, we're finally here. It was a wicked feeling.
But for us, it was our starting point. It was good that Pops lent their hand and let us on.
It was on that stage over there, and then I wore my Liverpool kit, Liverpool top, and it was excellent.
Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. Don't tell me what you want.
When we first did Top of the Pops, it was like, that is like, you've truly arrived.
It was a dream come true, really. So I felt like a proper pop star.
When I was on it, it was like, I can't believe I'm doing it.
To actually get onto Top of the Pops was like a childhood ambition.
It was like, finally doing it. Excellent.
Giving you everything, all that joy.
Bye.
Spice Girls are never blasé about anything because we know how fickle the pop industry can be. One minute you're up there, next minute you're down there, so you have to appreciate everything.
Every time we'd come and do a single, it was like a bit of a club. Do you know what I mean? You come down, you see the other artists, you know, there's always a warm crowd, you know, it's faces and cameramen that you know, and so, you know, we always look forward to it and very excited about it.
It's always really good fun. We're always here for the whole day. So, you know, we have a bit to eat and then we go in the bar afterwards. So it's really nice. It's a nice stage. I mean, really enjoy it. And it's nice and near my home as well.
You look around at all the little stage and I remember us saying, I want to be on that stage next time we come here. Or I want to be on that one. And just the logo and everything, it's just like you'd never... You know, I appreciate everything.
My favourite Top of the Pops that we ever done was last year's Christmas Top of the Pops because we were presenting it as well. And it was absolutely brilliant. It was nerve-wracking because like I've never done presenting before, but I really enjoyed it more than anything.
Words were, when I see you on Top of the Pops, I know that you've made it. So, and then he saw me and he was like, oh, you made it. Hold it down, feel the noise. Let them know it's a vibe, pick it up, it's alive. Move over, yeah, don't do it over. Cause it's over, yeah, yeah, yeah. A generation left. Next phase, next stage, next grave, next wave.
That's happening. I think they're just really proud. I mean, my mum takes everything that we do. you know, absolutely everything. And, you know, she's just really excited.
They still don't believe it's me, really. I think when they see me on the telly, they just think, oh, there's Mel C. They don't think it's me. Do you know what I mean? They think it's quite funny. They laugh at me. They take the mickey out of me.
Really excited to see us on it. It's madness.
It's like I'm saying hi to my mum, even though I probably wouldn't have seen her for about a month. She can see me on TV.
She used to be my only enemy. I never liked to be free. Catching me in places that I knew I shouldn't be. Every other day I crossed the line. I didn't mean to be so bad. I never thought you would become the friend I never had.
I would say I'm the joker and the fool of them all. You know, they really do take Mickey out of me a lot. And one time, I always looked like Calamity Jane, and it was quite a stressful day at Top of the Pops, and I got locked in the toilet.
Jerry's always getting out to the loo. Whenever we do anything right, and like it's like, oh, where's Jerry? Where's Jerry? And it's like, I bet she's in the toilet. And she's always in the toilet, honest to God. She spends her life on the toilet.
And so I was jammed in the toilet. And the funny thing is, I've got this obsession of leaving the toilet door open anyway, normally when I'm on the toilet.
I've walked in the loo and seen Jerry sat on the loo, but I've never actually got... But yeah, that's a habit of hers, you see.
It was a really stressful day, and so I just made it onto stage just in time. So that was a bit of a nightmare. I don't even think it was rehearsed, I think it was the real thing.
And she was running along and her little shoes going.
I don't lock it anymore. So beware, everyone in Top of the Pops. Don't lock the door.
The race is on to get out of the bottom. The top is high, so your roots are forgotten. Giving is good, as long as you're giving. What's driving you is ambition, I'm better.
I said, do you think you are?
we met here, Prince. That was a biggie.
We met Prince here.
We met Prince, which was amazing. We were up in our dressing room, and like us five, making lots of noise, running down the corridor, going, "We want to see Prince."
We went into his dressing room, even though his security was saying, "No, no, no, you can't go in."
Prince. I don't know if I can call him Prince anymore, can I? The artist came out of his door and he went, "Yeah, come in, girls." It was like, and all his bouncers sort of stood back and we walked in and we had that 5 minute chat with him and
met Sarah Brightman. I always used to really like her, she's very talented.
Prince is the ultimate person though. He really is.
Which is, I mean, one of the main songs from the movie.
When we were writing this song, it's quite special to me. It's like, you know, writing it, it's about someone who I care a lot about.
When we wrote it, it was on the film set, and we had a really good vibe between the five of us.
I love it because it reminds me of the film, you know, it brings back lots of good memories.
It's really good and lovely to perform. Every time I perform it, I get goosebumps. Every time, it's just like, you know, the music and everything in it is lovely. I love it anyway.
Love is blind as far as the eye can see. Deep and meaningless words to me. He's a lover. I need a friend. Written nowhere. Twist and turn. Too tight, all in.
a new single, obviously the movie coming out, the tour starting. We are really, really excited about it. There's a lot of surprises there as well. You know, a lot of things that people won't necessarily be expecting.
I think talking about, you know, really far ahead into the future, I mean, Spice Girls, we've got so much to do. You know, we're all really strong, we're really determined to, like, carry on and go from strength to strength. But obviously, you know, we're women, we wanna get married, we wanna have kids, there's loads of stuff we wanna do, but we're such good mates, we'll always be together.
I think the most important thing is our friendship, really. That is what Spice Girls is fundamentally about, it's friendship and music.
I think no matter what we do, though, whether it is solo or group, we'll all pop down and see each other. Be at the front going, ah! But who knows, I think as a group, I wanna do a lot more Top of the Pops. Thinking about something solo is like so much going on now. It's like, who knows what's going to happen.
Hopefully, if possible, I never want to do anything else. I can't do anything else. Do you know what I mean? It's like, this is it now. Now I've had me little time on Top of the Pops and, you know, me few little number ones and stuff. It's like, if it stops, then I don't know what I want to do.
I feel really happy, you know, that we're together. And I would like to say thank you to everybody that have supported us through ups and downs. So in times of adversity, you really find out who, you know, your friends are, really.
Us five girls, we're stronger than ever, and I think we're going to be around for as long as the public want us. You know, we want to be there for our fans. We've got so much more to do. We've got loads of ideas for more music. So hopefully we'll be around for a lot longer.
The people that really matter to us are our fans, and they've been absolutely fantastic. Got the best fans ever.
We might be doing Wannabe, you know, with Zimmer Frames on top of it. You still want us?
I'm giving you everything, all that joy can bring. This I swear,
I give you everything.
And all that I want from you is the promise you will be there.
Say you will be there, yeah.
I'm giving you everything,
I give you everything,
all that joy can
bring.
This I swear.